your bread and butter is thinking about security, but particularly you're looking at vulnerabilities when it comes to outsources of your workflow, the supply chain into your company. You've just been putting out some key reports, Wendi. What are the key findings at the moment?
Yeah, thanks, Caroline. I think it really ties into the story that you're talking about here, right? In terms of technology being disruptive, and that can be used for good. It can also be used for bad. And so I think our report really tells a story that we live every day, which is that banks, financial institutions, organizations, schools, cities throughout the world, they're all being targeted in particular by ransomware actors. And what we show is that these cyber criminals are becoming even more effective at doing their job. They do a great job of understanding what's in an environment and which data that they can steal. And stealing is a very important concept here, because what we're not seeing is just a traditional ransomware attack where an organization's data is encrypted, but we're seeing, much like nation state actors have done for years, we're seeing data being stolen and exfiltrated from environments and used for extortion. And attackers are doing that on a daily basis. They're not just threatening it, but we're actually seeing every 4 hours, we're seeing more organizations' data being posted.
Ed, with regularity and the stakes, well, becoming evidently more high.
Yeah, and there's a point that I wanted to make on ChatGPT, Wendi, which is that it impacted ChatGPT and also the premium tier, GPT Plus. While you could see the search titles of other users, you could not actually get into the conversation. So I want to be clear, you couldn't actually kind of access data relevant to other users, but it was basically deemed as a bug in the open source software. My question to you in the context of cybersecurity is, is this kind of issue an afterthought as people try to rush these products out? They don't think about kind of the base security of the software that they're writing.
So I think that software vulnerabilities across the board are challenging for every organization to deal with, and they're only going to become more of a problem just due to the scale that AI brings to the table, right? So we're going to continue to see these type of vulnerabilities. I think one thing that's exciting is that, last week was released a national cybersecurity strategy. And in that, we talk about, in particular, the need to protect, expand the definition of critical infrastructure. So, and the role that technology vendors and providers play in that, right? So we see that with these supply chain attacks becomes a major issue, but we're also seeing a lot more rapid information sharing that is becoming incredibly positive.
I'm reading over the results or your findings in this research. And Caroline, what's so interesting to me is the types of businesses found most vulnerable are those businesses we entrust with our data on a daily basis.
And I suppose also when we're thinking of keeping our own company protected, I don't know about you, done countless training exercises about knowing phishing, but smishing is a new one, Wendi, that you've been talking a lot about. What are the ways in which companies can protect themselves?
Yeah. So, we've talked so much about AI, right, and all the technology investments, but I think, Caroline, what you're getting at are the human side of that. I think one of the most compelling findings for us is that we've seen these attacks increase to now 20% of attacks that we deal with include a harassment element. And I would imagine that if we talk again in 2 months, we're going to see that number probably double. And what I mean by that is attackers are specifically going after security, so executives, their families, reaching out to them personally, their staffs, finding any way that they can to socially engineer data out of them. And that's going to become a continued incredibly compelling. And they're also getting super savvy about understanding how businesses work, right? So understanding that if I target not only your organization, maybe has a great security barrier and perimeter, but you have business process outsourcers that also have access to your most sensitive data. And there are employees in those environments that I can target equally effectively that have access to your environment. So we're going to continue to see that type of activity directed towards employees across the board.
And so how are companies protecting and assessing the vulnerabilities of their own supply chain?
Yeah, you know, I think one of the biggest keys is the mindset shift. And we are seeing so many organizations do that and actually win. So I think there's really a positive outlook here. And our report tells that story too, which is that so many organizations are effectively defending against these attacks because they identify them early. They practice their response. They understand that these attacks are going to come. It's simply part of hosting a business on the internet today. And they've got great relationships across the board, not only with experts, but also law enforcement who can really rapidly provide them answers, often in the form of decryptors that can, you know, render these attacks ineffective.
It is fascinating, Ed, when you're reading these sorts of data reports, is basically what the people, the attackers, are trying to set out to do here.
Right, and that's why our audience in particular should care, because they're going after finance. Yes, they're going after data and telecommunications. And the last one, which we have to discuss, Wendi, is cryptocurrency. Why are they targeting these specific areas? Is it just for financial gain?
Well, any avenue they have that makes it easier to move money is certainly going to be a target, right? So the more that we can work related to sharing information between public and private partnerships and stopping the ability of movement of cryptocurrency, for example, of disrupting attacker infrastructure, the more that we can do that, the more effective we are going to be against these attacks. And I think we are in a better place now in terms of that information sharing and being able to do it in a way that starts disrupting attacker infrastructure and really starting to stop some of these attacks.